Hello and welcome by AAS Arts. You know, my name is Joachim Wiersma and today I'd like to show you how I did design my next coming up painting. It's a surrealistic painting, which I'm really excited about because it's something that I have as an image in my imagination, and I wanted to paint it, obviously, but therefore I needed a kind of a reference photo. And but because it's surrealistic, it is not in one photo to get. So therefore I had to combine different photos, and also sometimes, not for this painting, but sometimes I have to do a little bit of adjustment and on those reference. So I would I needed to paint or draw in that photo. And that is possible with Photoshop, as you may know, and also with the iPad Pro. And I have the iPad Pro, as you can see, and I'm really, really happy with it because now, like I said, I can design my own paintings, and especially for the surrealistic paintings and drawings that I like to make, and I think I'm gonna make more of them because I really like them. This is a very, very handy tool, and I a few months ago I did buy my Photoshop, or I you pay a monthly amount and you can have access to the Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop if I'm correct, and also the Lightroom version. I have both of them. For this one I use the Photoshop. Now, yes, the Photoshop. And because I can now connect my iPad Pro to my PC, this is from Apple, and on my PC I have Windows, and those two are not combining very well, but I found a app that allows me to draw on my iPad Pro, and it shows up on also on my PC and on my screen. So I have my drawing and my pictures on the screen and also on my iPad Pro. And also I use this Apple Pencil. It's a very, very handy tool. There are more pencils, digital pencils. I'm sorry, I have a little bit difficulty with pronouncing that name, but yes, you can use different pencils to draw on your tablet, but I really like this Apple Pencil. And I came across of this Apple Pencil and also the iPad Pro because I watched quite a lot of tutorials on this subject. So therefore, I like to mention that I am really not an expert on this. I just did a lot of research, and I think I can do a lot of what I like. I can do a lot of designing my paintings, my you could say my pre-paintings, because I'm going to paint them on a canvas or drawing on a paper. But I did look up a lot of tutorials, so if you are interested in this subject and you would like to use it for your own artworks, I really suggest you are going to find some tutorials on this matter, because I am going to show you how I did it, but the chances are very, very big that I did don't know enough about, for example, the shortcuts. There are a lot of shortcuts that you should know for Photoshop. I think, because shortcuts are very handy, but I don't know them yet. So if you see something and you think you there is a shortcut for, or you have any tips, please be welcome to share them with me, because I'm still learning how to use Photoshop. But yeah, so that is what I'm going to do today. I'm going to design my painting. So the next tutorial will be the actual painting. And I'm very, like I said, very excited, because this is very new for me. And I have all the time those images in my head, and I couldn't find a way to get a good reference so I could paint them or draw them. Because painting or drawing from imagination, especially animals and the autonomy of the animals, another difficult word for me, but people are very, very different, very hard if you do try it from imagination. And there are some people who can do it, but I think most of us cannot do it. So therefore I like to have a reference. So, and like I said, now I'm able to make my own references, and let's start that tutorial about how I make my own references. And this is the Photoshop, like I said in the intro, and on your left hand side
from above to downwards, you have all kinds of different tools, different options, and one of them is the eraser tool. And that tool I'm using right now. I am basically I'm erasing the background from the main subject, and in this case it's the deer, because I only want to have the deer in my painting, and I want have want to have a different background and also different elements. So therefore I only need a deer from this photo, and therefore, like I said, I use the eraser tool. And what you see me doing now is adjust the size of the brush or the pencil, how you want to call it. But as you can see, I am using a teeny tiny brush now, a razor brush, to get in those little holes in the little spaces, I should say, in between his ear and his antlers, because I want to have that out of there as well, because it gives a nicer and better you can see it better when I'm using a background on my own. So therefore I like to use also the eraser tool for the teeny tiny little spaces in between some subjects, and especially in a main subject, it will help me to better define my details on the whole layer. So if I let some background stay there, it doesn't show up as well. So it takes some time to get the background out of there, but I really did take my time to get all of that out of this picture that I didn't need. And it's not that I like to do this, but I had to do it for myself, because I wanted as closely as I can in my reference photo, so I can really focus on those details and on the composition when I'm painting, and also in the composition, of course, while I'm making this digitally reference for my painting. And like I said, therefore I like to include a lot of details, and also on these edges of the antlers I try to get rid of that background as good as I can. And later on you will see why I'm doing this a bit better, where I try to explain it. And like I said, I didn't like really enjoyed doing this, but in the end it was really worth the effort and really the time that it took to finish this. And I will speed it up now about now, because now we have a general idea what I'm doing. And if for the bigger pieces I normally use a bigger brush, here you can see the bigger brush, it's just a little bit easier. But now I can avoid the teeny tiny lines, and therefore I use a little a smaller eraser, like I said. So this is basically it. Sometimes I just grab the image. You can do that by select the image and drag it a little bit up and down, so I can see if I did miss some spots in the background, because I now I have a transparent background, so therefore I can erase the original background. And you do that with on the right hand side. You have the images, you will have your layers there. It's on your right hand side, and then in a corner. It's kind of hard to explain it like this, but you can work with different layers. And there I select the layer, and there is a little slot on the next to that layer, and if you click on it you can get your background transparent. And you want to have a transparent background, otherwise you cannot erase it. As you can see now, I have three layers in there, and that is changing because I'm working on those layers. But that is the basic idea. And like I said in the intro, if you do not completely understand what I'm talking about, please do some research on tutorials who all are only about that subject that I did talk about the transparent layers. And also you want to have you want to know how to make different layers in Photoshop, because I'm using quite some different layers, and that is very, very handy. I will show up later on in this tutorial why I am choosing quite some different layers. Because as you may have seen in the intro, that where I did show the photo that I'm working on now, what I'm making now, I did have quite some different subjects there. I had the deer painting and also some mushrooms, and most of them, and also the moon, and most of them are from Pixabay. They are copyright free, so therefore I like to search quite a while for my subjects. I really take the time. I have, like I said, that image in my mind, and I want to make this as closely as possible, because that will make it a lot easier for me to paint later on. So I downloaded that moon, and I will do basically the same process with the moon. I will click on that slot next to the layer of the moon, and later on that will make the background transparent, and then I am able to erase that background. You will see me do that now. I started with the moon. Now I do show a few of them. Like I said, I have also some mushrooms. I will not show you the whole process, because this, as you can imagine, this takes some time. But these are the steps I'm going through, and also what I do is adjusting the color. As you can see now, I'm making it a little bit lighter, a little bit darker. Just I try to get it as close as I think it's gonna suit in my picture. I can adjust it later on once again, because I'm working in different layers. That's why it's very important to have different layers in Photoshop while working on a particular picture. But yeah, I love that orange, reddish, warm color, and that is what I'm trying to find now. So I do some different options. I've tried some different options here, and until I like it. And it's quite easy to adjust the color in Photoshop. There are different ways to do it, and I'm just trying some things out. But as you can see, it does change quite a lot, and it does change more and more, like that orange reddish color that I really like. And I'm now trying some purple, but that was obviously not the color that I liked. But sometimes I do a little hint of purple also in my paintings, because it makes it a little bit deeper, a little bit richer. And you cannot see the purple now, but it makes it more transparent, I could say, the orange of the moon. It makes it more, richer. I think that is the best word to describe that. And now I select the picture. No, I didn't select the picture, I'm sorry. I adjust the size of the picture. That was what I tried to say, but because I don't need a whole background, I only need the moon, and it saves me a little bit time with erasing it. And it's also very easy to adjust the size of your pictures there. So I start out with just a general size of picture, and then I can adjust it quite easily in Photoshop. And once again, I'm erasing that background, because I don't need that, and the moon is not perfectly around, and that's okay by me. I just need a nice idea how it will look in my painting, and I can make it as round as possible in my actual painting later on. And now I'm using the airbrush tool. I just want to get rid of that real light section on the on that left hand side of the moon, and a bit of the whole moon I'm airbrushing as well. So I try to get rid of that light, but I have a slightly different color, so therefore I apply it at the whole moon, so it makes more sense. Otherwise you can see the transitions between the different colors a little bit too much. And I really like the airbrush tool in Photoshop for this. It makes a very nice, smooth layer, I should say, of different colors. So therefore I found myself using that airbrush brush quite a lot. And now I'm adjusting the background color. I would like to have it as dark as possible, but not straight black, because black is a little bit too cold and too harsh. So therefore I basically use now a very dark a reddish brown color that shows up as black, but it is richer than just the standard black, if that makes sense. If you're not sure if you like this kind of black color, you can use another black and just compare the two, and then you will see the difference. It's now very hard to notice. It just looks straight black, but it's a very, very dark brown. And here, while I was talking about the background, you see me including the moss and some mushrooms. And the moss was kind of funny, because like I said, I do work in different layers. This is another layer on top of the deer and also the moon. And that gives me the ability to cut out different pieces of moss, as you see me doing here. And I cut them, then I select them, and put them on sections where I wanted moss, as you see me doing here. And the nicest thing of have different layers is that you can erase the moss that is falling over that section of the antler. And I will show it for you in a minute. But now I'm just cutting and pasting the moss around where I want to have it. It's quite roughly, but I will make it smoother by using that eraser pencil again. And because of the different layers, like I said, that other layer will show up. And in this case, the other layer is the deer and the antler. So that antler will show up through the moss, and that will give it a much more natural look, because the moss is not completely over the deer. I want to be it on top of his head, and to create that feeling I need to have pieces back of that deer, and like I said, in this case it's all about the antlers. But and you see me erasing here a little bit of a background of a mushroom. I did forget it, and I did erase it, and then the moon did show up again, because that's the underlayer. Once again, if it doesn't make sense completely, please search for some tutorials about this subject. There are a lot of tutorials who are going a lot of more in depth about this technique than I do, but it's really, really helpful. You can make basically anything that you have in mind. You just search for the right photos and adjust them. You can adjust the colors, you can adjust the sizes, and also you can combine them like I am doing here. And more and more it does show up as the image that I wanted to have. And as you look closely, there is a snail house, or a snail, I don't know how you call it, but it's a snail. I thought it was a fun little detail there. And also I have a leaf just on right above his eye, and some mushrooms. In the end, I did lose some of the mushrooms, but just a few of them. So in the end painting, which will be up hopefully next week, you will see a lot of mushrooms on there. I just really like these images, and like I said, it's surrealism, and that means that you can basically do anything you want. You can paint anything within this painting as you like it. So therefore, it's so much fun painting and drawing this way. And now even more, now I know how to make my own references this way. It's just it gives you more kind of stability while you're painting, because I don't have to think about the compositions anymore, because I did all that work in Photoshop. And now this is finished, this is the end piece, I just can have this on my screen, and I just can start drawing and then painting right away. And so therefore I found this a very, very useful and nice method to make your own references basically for your paintings and drawings.
So I hope you like this tutorial, and I don't know why, but I have such a difficulty with pronouncing the digital T words, digitally painting, digitally drawing pencils. It's kind of hard work, so excuse me for that. I know I do it the wrong way, but I hope you understand what I'm talking about. And like I said, I hope you like this tutorial, and If you have any tips or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below, because I really like to learn more about this. And what I also mentioned in the intro is that I'm going to do a lot of more, I'm planning to do a lot of more of these kind of paintings and drawings, just because I'm liking them so much, and I have a lot of this sort of pictures in my mind that I like to paint or draw. It's just, this is me. This is me as an artist. And once in a while I like to, of course, do photorealism and just use a reference photo, because I like to do that as well. It's such a wonderful of painting or drawing, if you ask me. But yes, I have a lot of images that I want to work on now, and I think I can do it now. I had to learn a lot about the techniques, and I try to share all those techniques that I am learning and I'm finding while I'm working, while I'm painting or drawing. But I think I needed that time to get these paintings as I have them, as I see them, as I want them to be on the canvas, on that paper. So therefore I'm really excited for this new year and what I'm going to come up with, and I hope you are too, and I hope you like my channel. And if you already subscribed, thank you. If you didn't have but you like this tutorial, please subscribe, because I'm gonna make more of these kind of tutorials. So thank you for watching, and like I said, if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. For now, I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye.